Wanna do a quick mail call. Got Chris Donatone's new shop card, CD scale models. He does mostly muscle cars. Go check him out. That looks like a 72 CUDA from those ribbings on that grill divider. I really like the low profile tires, but it's just orange and black, which is typical for the Mopars around the late 60s, early 70s with those crazy colors, like crazy purple, hemi orange, bright yellow, lime green. So go check Chris out. Thanks for the card, Chris. Next I have Hobby Dude 007, Buck Batson. I remember when he was crowdsourcing everyone's opinion on his shop card, but this is a really nice Dodge Daytona. I have the 69 Dodge Charger, but I don't have a winged bird yet, so I gotta get my hands on a Revelle Dodge Daytona or Plymouth Superbird, but I like how it's being worked on. You can see all the detail, but in a way it kind of reminds me of Luke Skywalker's speeder, because it's kind of like suspended in midair, kind of. So go check out Mark's channel, Hobby Dude. I remember he built this panel delivery, but it's basically a mobile workshop to build models. And the details inside the van was really incredible. So go check him out. I'll have both channels in my description. Go check them out if you haven't done so already. And thanks again for the words in the back. Alright, so before I start my 32 Ford Coupe, I'm going to make some part swaps with my other kit. This is probably like my favorite 32 Ford. It's the Deuce Coupe from American Graffiti. It's the first time I saw a 32 Ford, and I really like the Deuce Coupe, the way it's cut and chopped. So the parts I'm going to be switching is... The American Graffiti came with Corvette valve covers. So I'm gonna take these valve covers, it says Corvette, which is a Chevy valve cover, and these carburetors with the two round air cleaners. I'm gonna swap them to the Ford because I intend to build it with the hood, so it'll cover it up anyway. I'm gonna take these six Strombergs along with just the finned valve covers and put them on here, because this doesn't have a hood, so it's going to be more prominent, the engine. And I believe the movie car did have six Strombergs, and it did not have the Corvette on the valve cover. So to make this a little bit more accurate, I mean, great kit subject matter by AMT Ertl, or what used to be an MPC kit, and creating a movie car, but I'm going to swap some parts out, so that's how I'm going to start off. Alright, everyone. So, since this was an open box kit, the previous owner already removed some of the parts from the parts trees, which is something different from what I usually do. I usually spray them on the tree. So I'll just do a quick review of the parts. Here's the chrome pieces. Looks very nice. Just bear in mind that some of these parts will not be used because there's three variations that you can build. That look like one of the original carbs, engine halves, backing for the probably spokes, another engine block. So some of these are custom engine blocks, some of these are stock engine blocks, the radiator, belts, manifolds, front suspension. I'll probably be using these steelies. These are those beautiful spokes look nice if I painted them in red. These look like louvers for the hood. Exhaust pipes. Fan belt. Fan. Instrument panel. Those are valve cover and carbs. The metal axles. This is the bulk of the kit right here. The body, interior, frame. I probably will most likely spray paint the fenders black as opposed to just all red. Simple interior, so it's a simple kit because the model, the 32 Ford is a very simple kit. These are the colors I'll be using, gloss black, red, red primer, silver, and the interior will be nutmeg. The tires, these are fat, meaty tires. They look like Goodyears. A little dusty, I have to clean them. And these are the original skinnies. I will not be needing them, using them. I think they're Firestones. Yep, Firestones. So that's about it. I'll be back. Oh, the decals. I will not be using the decals because they're mostly like drag and pinstriping, which I probably don't use. I did like the Deuces of Wild, but probably will not use any decals. Save them. Okay, be back when everything's painted. Just want to show you guys, check out the flashing on this tire. They're a little harder to remove than on the plastic pieces that you just rip off with your fingers. Because if you cut too deep, you cut into the rubber. But wow, check out the flashing on that. Interesting enough, it's only that one mold. All the other ones have like minor ones on the tread, which is expected. But this one's not as bad. Just a little. And then these fat, meaty ones are not too bad. Alright, everything's back from painting. So I think I finally figured out this Rust-Oleum 2X. As long as you spray everything within 30 minutes, or you have to wait 48 hours. So what I did was, I sprayed the red primer to get this deep red. So it's red primer, and as soon as it's no longer has a shiny sheen and it starts to dry, I sprayed the red on top, and then I waited like 5 or 10 minutes, possibly 15 minutes, and then I sprayed the clear gloss coat. So it came out pretty good, the red. Not too bad. I think I'm gonna start doing this from now on. Just spray from primer to clear coat all within 20 or 30 minutes. So now it's ready to go. I mean, it's not a perfect paint job, but I'll maybe try polishing it up a little bit, but it's not bad. The red really looks good. Of course, when I make quick passes at it, you have to spray the nozzle. You have to press the nozzle all the way down. No partial spraying. It has to be full spray. The slight dimple right there, because what happens is that the spray came out perfect, and then when I stuck it in here, since I don't have that fluorescent sponge, it hit something. So I had to spray back over it like 2 or 3 times, but slight blemish if you see it. Did a dot. Everything else is sprayed, so I'm gonna continue to assemble it. Still have to mask off and do the top in black. And the running board, what do you call that? The non-slip in black. And then I think I might have to spray the inside. Nutmeg. Like the interior. Alright, I'll be back when some parts are assembled.